Hi everyone, today I want to show you how to use p5js and StableDiffusion together using latent consistency model. It runs locally on Apple Silicon Mac without using any cloud services. There are already quite a few different ways you can run StableDiffusion models, sometimes using paid services in the cloud or even on your Mac. There are a few open source projects available. But the method that I'll be showing you today is a bit different in that what you feed into these models is not only text prompts or existing images, but it can also come from your own p5js sketch. So I want to just briefly show you what it does, and then we'll move on to how to set it up on your own machine. And the code that I use today, I will leave a link to download it in the description. So let me refresh the web page, and I have a very simple setup in my P5. You can see in my draw function, I have a background gradient that's going from orange at the top to the light gray at the bottom. And then I have exactly two ellipses, which are set in dark red or brown color. And I will send this very simple image to the AI model, latent consistency model, with the prompt teddy bear. And when I click on my canvas and hit G key, it will start generating an image. It doesn't take too long. So that's what's really nice about this latent consistency model, that the image generation speed is really, really fast. If you have a really good computer, it might be almost real time. And on my M1 MacBook Pro, it took roughly about 3-4 seconds. So this is the image we get back. And we can stop here and save it. Or what we can also do is feed this image, generated image, back into the model to get different variations or to add more details. So I'm gonna just hit G key one more time. And then we get this image back. So you can do this as many times as you want, or you can always come back to your code and change some code to say different color or different shapes and generate images. And there's another script that's included in my project. This one was called codedrawing.js, but there's another one called mouse drawing. And to run it, I'm gonna have to go to index.html and uncomment that script. And in this version, it has a very minimal UI. Here in the text field, you can write your own prompt. So not only you can control the prompt with code, this string variable, but you can also do it in the text field here. So let me first generate it. Sunrise over Pacific Ocean, early morning. And then we get this image back. So we can generate one more time, feed it back into the model. But what we can also do is to paint over it. So if I pick some color, I'm gonna draw some sailboats. And then add the sailboat to the prompt. And generate one more time. And now we get this image back. You might have seen a similar example using StableDiffusion like this. But again, what's different here is that we can connect it to our p5js sketch on the HTML5 canvas. Next, I want to show you how to set it up on your own machine. Again, I'll leave a link to download the project files in the description. And once you download it, you can unzip it and maybe unzip it to desktop. And the first thing you'll need to do is go into your terminal and cd into that folder. Whatever the folder is named, just cd into it. Once you're in the project folder, we need to do two things. First one is setting up Python backend server. This is where our StableDiffusion latent consistency model will be running. And the second thing to do is to run another local server, so that we can work with P5 sketch. And let's handle the Python server first. So there is a prerequisite. You need to have Python installed on your Mac. What I suggest is to use some kind of virtual environment, because a lot of machine learning projects have a very different dependencies, different versions. So if you only have one Python version, it's very likely that you will break something. So what I use is Miniconda. If you search online, it'll be pretty easy to find and download it. I can't go over installing and setting it up in this video, but once you have set it up, you'll have to restart the terminal and then type this command conda space dash dash version. And if you see the version number, then it is correctly installed. If you see something like command not found, then you'll need to do some problem solving. So with the conda installed, we can create a new virtual environment using conda create command. So I will use this command conda create dash n, and this will be the name of the virtual environment that we are creating now. I just named it LCM, which stands for latent consistency model, but you can name it any way you want. And then we will pass an option to install Python along with it. And I'm using 3.11. So hit enter and you can just hit yes, why. Once it's done, you can follow this command. Activate this environment by running conda activate and the name of your environment. And after you activate the environment, you will see somewhere in your terminal prompt that name has changed from base to the name of your environment, which in my case is LCM. And you're ready to move on to the next step, which is to install dependencies for our backend server. Make sure you are in the project directory and then go into backend directory. There are many files in this directory, one of which is requirements.txt, which has a list of dependencies that we need to install. So we'll run another command called pip install -r requirements.txt. I've already installed a lot of the dependencies that it's using. So it's only using cached version, but if it's first time you are installing these packages, it'll take some time. And once all the dependencies are installed, then we can start running the server by running this command, python serve.py. First time you are running this command, it's gonna take some time because it needs to download the model, which takes up about 3-4 gigabytes. So it's gonna take some time, but again, I already have downloaded. So in my case, it was pretty instant. After the models are downloaded and you see this loading pipeline component and some logging message, then it is ready to use. So that's the backend server setup. Now it's time to work on the frontend to run our p5js sketch. So keep this window open and I will open up a new terminal window or tab. Let me move up one level up to the main directory if you are still in the backend directory. And here we will run npm install command. So to use npm, you will have to have Node.js installed. So npm install and then npm run dev. So this is another local server we are running that handles the front end side of our project, which is a p5js sketch. Then you can visit this URL. So again, make sure you have all these two windows running at the same time. And then you can use any code editor you use to edit the p5js code. And here is my setup. I have this code editor open, but I also moved Python server window to the bottom here so I can see what's going on, because sometimes it throws an error and I want to see it when it happens. We don't have to touch any backend code. Everything will be done with p5sketch. So let's go into source folder and open up codedrawing.js. And this p5sketch is running in the instance mode. And we have prompt, so you can update to whatever you want to generate. And there's width and height of the generated image, which is also the size of the canvas. You may try some different variations, but it really depends on the RAM available on your machine. If you try too high resolution, it will throw an error. And the seed is pretty important. Right now, it is randomized every time you refresh the page. But if you want to get the same image again and again, try to fix the seed here. And the feedback variable is if you want to feed generated image back into the model and regenerate based on the previous image. If you don't like it, you can just set it to false. And down in the draw function, this is where you will be adding your own sketch code. You can just simply delete all of this here, except for the last line, which is used to toggle between generated image and your original P5 drawing. So for instance, if I generate an image with pressing G key, then I can press spacebar to toggle between the original sketch and the generated image because of this line of code, and key pressed space here. And you don't have to deal with much of the rest of the code, but one thing you might want to experiment with is steps. This is the model's inference steps. If you increase this value, you will get better detailed image, but it's going to take more time. Latent consistency model is really nice that it can still generate pretty good image using very low inference steps. So I suggest you try somewhere between 1 and 4. And the strength here is how well it will follow your prompt. So you can try a value between 0 and 1. I find it somewhere between 0.6 and 0.8 gives me a pretty good result. And the outdoor is where the generated image will be saved, because the Python server will save every image you generate. And I set it to output folder, but you can change that. That's pretty much it. So there's not much you need to worry about in terms of what's going on with the communication between the server and our P5 code. Just a few variables. And the rest is just making your own sketch using, line, ellipses, and rect, all the familiar p5.js functions. That's code drawing. And the mouse drawing is not that different. It's got the same prompt, width and height, and seed. There are a few extra variables to control mouse drawing. Drawing state, true or false, and brush size. And setting up some DOM elements like color picker, text field, and button. And again, inside the draw function, replace these function calls with your own, depending on what you're trying to generate. And here with the key press of square brackets, you can control the brush size. And then we have the same steps and strength that you can play with. And that's pretty much it. So I hope you have some fun, and I'll see you in the next video.